Back is still on the Be Bold Show, and well, if you've just joined us, you've missed quite a lot. Get onto our website and check out what you've missed. But we've been looking at media, we've been looking at journalists, writers, and now we're on to
our sickle cell project. For us, it's very important that whatever you do in life, always remember to give back. And what we started was a sickle cell project where we are looking at educating everybody out there about sickle cell and getting that, what was it, Crystal? A transcranial Doppler, which is $30,000, and we are trying to get that together to get that to the Kolebu Children's Ward. So let's have a look what is happening with the sickle cell project this week.
My first clear picture of what this disease was when I was a student in the U.S. Mm-hmm. And then I went to medical school. I wanted to be a pediatrician, was interested in infectious diseases because I thought that would be useful in Ghana. And towards the end of my medical school education, well, right in the middle of medical school, I also used to run for Ghana. I used to be athletics. Yeah, I used to do athletics for Ghana. For a long time, I was Ghana's champion hurdler. And so even when I was in university at Yale, running for Yale, I also used to run for Ghana at the same time. And in 1968, the Olympics were held in Mexico City, which is a high altitude. And there was some concern that people with sickle cell trait, AS, may have trouble at the high altitude because it's a lower oxygen, you know, level. And so in the U.S., and I suppose even in Africa, there was interest in urging athletes to find out what their sickle cell status was. And so my team manager at Yale was actually the first to advise me because I had been selected to be on the Ghana team and said, you know, Frempong, you should know. So I was tested in 1968. That's when I first found out that I was AS.
And
I was, AS. And I didn't, you know what it meant. Eventually, I didn't go to the Olympics because there was this South Africa invitation and boycott. And by the time the boycott was, by the time the invitation was rescinded so that the boycott was over, I had actually started classes and I decided I'm not going to cancel that semester to go. But that's when I became aware of it. And it didn't really, you know, personally, it didn't affect me much other than my sense of this, my cousin's disease. But it became very real when, after I graduated with my first degree 2 years later in 1970, the young woman that I wanted to marry also, actually we got married before we found out that she too was AS. So our first child is SS. He's 40 years old now.
Well, everybody, please keep those donations coming in. They're so important. As you see, it is a big issue in our society. And, you know, we need to help them. We really do.
Yeah. I mean, it's something that is the awareness creation. I mean, a lot of people don't know what sickle cell is. So I think today, at least you've been educated a little bit more about it. And even if you don't have anything to give, at least you know something of it and you can take, you just know, it's just good to know.
Yeah.
Well, guys, unfortunately, this marks the end of our episode. But guess what? Next week, we have Alberta Ampoma. I don't know if some of you know her, but she's a weight lifter that just finished, went, I mean, if you were watching the Olympics, I'm sure you saw her on there, and we had a chance to interview her, and next week you'll see her, and you know how she goes about her training, what it was like for her to be in the Olympics, and then you also get to see the team lifting some weights. Let's see how Sarah did, how I did, how the team members did, and you'll be the judge. But it's very exciting, so you don't want to miss out on that.
Definitely, but that's not it, because we still have a few giveaways to give to everyone. First of all, we have the So Aesthetic goodie bag. You will find out what's in there. Now, if you remember from last week, we gave away a full makeover to a lucky lady, so I hope she enjoyed that. But for now, we have this, so you can find that. Go to our Facebook page, comment, like, and see, you might be the one that goes home with this. And what else do we have?
We also have three t-shirts to give away. the first person to call the Be Bold line right now. So start calling. First three people to call it are going to win the t-shirt.
Definitely.
And we'll announce that also on Facebook who the lucky winners were. But that's it. That marks the end of this. But guys, I hope you loved our outfits for today.
Definitely.
Peachy Purr and Kemi did that nice shirt that she has on there.
Definitely.
And also So Aesthetic Makeup that did all our makeup and styling for today. Who
and
else? House of Kramer, who styled all of our clothes today.
Definitely.
As well. A big thanks to all of them and for the team for making this possible.
Definitely.
Today.
And remember, always be bold, follow your dreams, and we hope we inspire somebody today to get a job in the media.
Yes, bringing education and building opportunity for leadership and development. Have a great day.
Bye.
Bye.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. It is corny, but it is so true. And us at the Be Bold Show team hope that you guys had as wonderful a Christmas as we did. Now, obviously, not everybody celebrates Christmas, but it is a time of the year to just reflect on what has been happening over the past year and to see what you want for your future. And obviously, it is a time to share with our loved ones. So today, in the Christmas spirit and into the new year, we are going to look at what everybody has been doing for their Christmas, how they see their new year, and what they hope for their life in general.
I'm Nanase, a taxi driver in Papua. Christmas means is that that's the birth of Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. So whilst the year has ended, and whilst by God's grace nothing has happened.
To me, Christmas means spending time with friends and family. Unfortunately, being in Ghana, I was unable to attend my family function this year, but I spent it at the beach in Axim. Gorgeous.
Okay, actually I didn't do anything much because of the nature of my work and that stuff, so I didn't do anything. It was so stressful that I couldn't do anything.
Thank God, because life is there. Thank God for everything. We believe next year will be better than this year.
Yeah.
Sure.
Well, you've heard it from the sellers. Kweku, you as a cameraman for the Be Bold Show, how has your Christmas been?
It's been amazing. It's been great. I've been in the house planning on how to improve in the upcoming year and planning on how the Be Bold Show would move to the next level.
Wow.
And that is what I've been doing. For
that's what's
on
up.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I think that sums it up really. We want to get better, go forward and show you guys what we have in store for you. But till then, we wish you a Merry Christmas
and
a Happy New Year.
Be
bold. See you next year.
See you.
Bye.
Let's all stand up tall and be wise and be bold. I stand up tall and I'm wise and I'm bold. I stand up tall and be wise and be bold. Be wise and be bold. Be wise and be bold. Stand up tall and be wise and be bold. I stand up tall and I'm wise and I'm bold. I stand up tall and be wise and be bold. Be wise and be bold. Be wise and be bold. Show. Everybody needs something. Take a step, make a move, action. Insecurities only make a victim. To be the one then, love your blood genes, love who you are. Express how you think, can't flex with your ID like you do with BB pants. Back then like Titanic, I sink. But it's a good day, I can hear the bed sink. I got a quick edge like a violin string. Now the pain keeps falling, now we flowers in spring. And be wise and be bold. At least in your thoughts, be a queen or a king. Stand up tall and be wise and be bold. I stand up tall and I'm wise and I'm bold.